Well, next week, the last player in this series stars Anthony Bate and Pauline Yates in To Kill a King. Leap in the Dark at 10:15 next Friday evening.
There's a variety of new programmes starting next week on BBC2. From Monday to Friday, 6:55 special with Sally James and American superstar David Soul, who talks in the new Radio Times about his appetite for fresh challenges. And on Tuesday...
He's Simon Bates.
And excuse me, but she's Gillian Miles.
Who hosts the start of Food and Drink, examining the what, why, when and where of our food consumption. Also on Tuesday, a series with a watery flavour, The Past Afloat.
And out of all that great fleet of wherries, this is the last remaining working wherry. The Albion, built in 1898.
Anthony Burton looks at working ships from the past that have survived and the museums in which they're preserved. Radio Times locates these museums and visits one in the Lake District to find the brass and varnish still in good working order. And later on Tuesday, a major season of John Ford films opens with John Wayne in Stagecoach.
Will you give me your word you won't try to escape again?
I'll give you my word. The Lordsburg.
Radio Times looks at the background to this film, which marked the start of a famous Hollywood partnership. And a colour feature previews next week's two Noel Coward masterpieces starring Paul Scofield. Friday's play also stars Deborah Carr.
Well, I'm still waiting to hear the reason for this, shall we say, rather tardy reappearance in my life.
Paul Scofield in two roles by Noel Coward, who looks down on the cover of the new Radio Times.
Well, in 5 minutes, Dean Martin's Comedy Classics, a look back at some of the television comedy shows starring Dean Martin, with the assistance of such Hollywood stalwarts as Frank Sinatra, Bob Newhart, Peter Falk and Goldie Hawn, introduced by Orson Welles. Well, that's after the news headlines from Michael Burke.
Mr. Roy Jenkins has been elected as the first leader of the Social Democratic Party. In a postal ballot of the SDP membership, Mr. Jenkins polled 26,256 votes against 20,864 cast for Dr. David Owen. Our political editor says Dr. Owen, though defeated, achieved a respectable total which will provide him with a platform for the future. It's thought likely Mr. Jenkins will now be accepted by the Liberals as leader of the SDP Liberal Alliance. Mr. Jenkins says his aim is to take the Alliance to victory in the next general election. Sunday's threatened rail strike is still on. The drivers' union leader, Ray Buckton, says the strike won't be lifted until British Rail withdraw the new flexible rosters, although the union has offered to introduce them experimentally in some areas. British Rail, in turn, say they won't discuss the rosters until ASLEF calls off the strike. In the Commons, the Transport Secretary, David Howell, said the strike would be the most pointless for half a century. The president of the Mine Workers' Union, Arthur Scargill, has pledged the miners' support for ASLEF. Coal normally moved from the pits by rail will not leave by any other means, he says. Police hunting for the gunman in North Yorkshire say the public should keep on reporting anything suspicious. They say they're getting closer to the suspected triple killer through the help of the ex-paratrooper who's a tracking expert. The search is still centred near the town of Malton. In Lebanon tonight, the state radio reports that the PLO has agreed to withdraw to an unspecified Arab country. But they've arranged with the Lebanese government that 500 PLO guerrillas will stay on until both Israeli and Syrian forces have left the country. Wolverhampton Wanderers have called in the receivers after running up debts of £2.5 million. But the club, which was relegated to the second division last season, is hoping to find some way to continue playing league football. Spain and the holders Argentina are out of the World Cup. West Germany's 2-1 victory over Spain means that England have to win by at least two clear goals in their match against the hosts on Monday. Well, that's all from us. Good night.
Well, now the weather, and in Scotland, Northern Ireland, Wales and Northern England, showers will become quite widespread tomorrow, with a few brighter spells between. South East England will have cloudy weather at first, with a little rain in the morning. This will move away to leave a brighter spell, but showers will set in later in the afternoon. Temperatures will be rather lower than today, and that's the weather. In 45 minutes, meet the Desisi brothers, otherwise Donald Sutherland and Gene Wilder, in our late-night historical romp, Start the Revolution Without Me. You're watching BBC One.
On BBC One tomorrow night, one of Dean Martin's guests takes the floor on his own in Sinatra, the Man and His Music.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. Don't want to leave her now. Better be leaving how. I don't plan to leave her now.
Frank Sinatra in a non-stop spectacular of top shows with his guests Count Basie and his band in Sinatra, The Man and His Music, tomorrow night at 9:55 on BBC One.
And now Orson Welles pops up again, this time to introduce our late film, which takes us on a manic extravaganza through 18th century French history. Start the revolution without me.